Morning, folks. Dave here on the plot. What a lovely day it is as well. You wouldn't think so. It was snowing and all that yesterday. Anyway, I'm going to go and get changed. I'm going to get the kettle on because that's the first thing you should do. I'm going to shift them and I'll before I come a cropper. See you in a bit.
Dave at the allotment. Dave, what are you after this afternoon? Still cracking on at the allotment. Get the kettle on. It's Dave at the allotment. See you in a bit.
Right, well, the rain scuppered me plans for the day because I was going to start planting stuff out, but it's too cold, it's been snowing, and it's been treacherous rain for the past 3 days or something, so the ground's soaking wet, but I've got some things to put on. So, after me cuppa, see you in a bit. I'm just busy putting on this kale into the cups. The pre-hold cups used, made by a candle. Quick tip. Yeah, these are the kale that were, I grew them in the windowsill propagating frames from B&M's. They're quite good, but the only thing what I found is they're quite hard to get out from the actual thing without breaking them, you know, or disturbing the roots. Breaking them, basically. That's the pot and the plant. Oh, you see, that's what happens. They just fall out. Now, that one doesn't look too healthy anyway, so I just put that to one side. I potted all my seeds on in Humax. And like I say, look, it's fantastic. Almost 100% germination with everything I've planted so far. Oh, see, I didn't want to disturb the... If you only use the pots once, then it's not... Hey, this isn't going to plan, folks, at all. Luckily, that one didn't snap. So that's not the way to get them out. And or like breaking these, which you don't want to really, it's pointless spending £2 odd on these to use them once. So I'm putting this in, half filled it with a compost. Look at the roots on that. Held by the seed leaves, of course. And then, when they've got hold of it, it's firmed down. Nice, gentle firming. Of course, don't hit the stem, because that's it, you're knackered then. So let's see if I can actually get one of these out without them falling or without breaking this pot. See, come out, will you? Oh, look at that. Well, folks, that isn't the way to do it, but it's working, so I'm getting away with things. turned into a nice day there. I thought it was going to start raining again, but it hasn't. Still a bit nippy. In fact, I'll show you the barometer later. Well, I'm going to crack on with the rest of these and not bore you to death. So I'll see you in a bit. Well, while I'm here, I'm going to pot on these sunflowers. These are the little Leos. It's quite hard to say that. I keep wanting to say little yellow. Little Leo. I planted these at the same time as the kale. Look, the roots are coming through the bottom there now, so they need planting on. By rights, they should be outside, but not while the weather's like this. There's an old saying, never cast a clout till May's out. Now, I always thought that was, that it meant the month of May. Oh, hey, I'm going to get... Just come out where he is. There's one out anyway. Aye, that's the only thing with these pots. They're a nightmare to get the things out, like. A bloody nightmare. Right, come out this time, please. I'll give it a bit of a squeeze at the bottom to loosen it off. That's it. I think I've got it. Right, that's loosened that off, so come on. There, that's it. Good old seed leaves. Right, I'm going to get on with the rest of these. I'm going to stick the kettle on and listen to the gardening program. Hello, matey. Come on in. Come on in, come on up. Hello, matey. Are you going to keep the slugs away from me? Go on in there then. Well, I'll take this bit over. Well, the sun's blazing out there now. It's quite warm. The ground's still a bit wet though, because like I say, it's been raining for the past 3 days. And it even snowed last night. So, but anyway, I've come in here because what I'm going to do, it's the ground's too wet to dig, but it's not too wet to get prepared. Stage two. So I'll tell you about it in here because it's a bit windy outside and you'll probably not be able to hear us. So I've got me land, I've dug it over. Now I'm going to get me rotavator on the go. Get one of the potato trenches ready. But what I'm going to also do is, I've got my chicken pellets. I'm going to put them in there and then give it another quick rotivate. So I'll get on with that.
I'm going to fill the kettle. I'm going to sow some seeds. I'm going to dig the garden. Get rid of all the weeds. I'm going to plant some flowers. Gonna plant some veg. I'm gonna pick some blackberries when they grow on my hedge. But first, I'm gonna put the kettle on. Gonna have a brew, 'cause that's the first thing you should do.
Too right it is.
days. I'm gonna wait for sunshine. I'm gonna wait for rain. I'm gonna wait for springtime. Then it starts all over again. But first, I'm gonna put the kettle on. Gonna have a brew. Cause that's the first thing you should do.
Right, so that's that. Now what I'll do, I'll leave it, because it's far too early for potatoes up here in the northeast. I've had a few comments asking, when do you put me potatoes in? Not yet. Just keep watching me videos, I'll tell you, I'll keep these all right. Especially up here in the northeast, like I say. Because I know a lot of people have put potatoes in already, but that's down south. And, like I say, it's still been frosty at nights. I'll show you the barometer. Thermometer thing later. But anyway, like I was saying, the trench has now been filled and then rotovated with the chicken pellets. Next stage, which like I say isn't yet, I'll dig a little trench out, and what I'm going to do is put the comfrey leaves on the bottom of the trench. Then I'll leave it again for another week or so. Then I'll put the potatoes in, fill the trench back up, sprinkle a bit more chicken pellets on it, and that's it. Done. Now another little job I'm going to do today, and I'll tell you about it in here because you'll not be able to hear us outside. My flower wildlife area, I'm going to sow them wildflower seeds today, whether they like it or not. See what happens. I'm itching to get going. Things need to start growing. So I'll get on with that, and I'll see you in a bit.
I'm gonna prune some roses. I'm gonna prune some trees. Make sure there's plenty pollen. I wanna save the bees. I'm gonna wait for sunshine. I'm gonna wait for rain. I'm gonna wait for springtime. Then it starts all over again. But first, I'm gonna put the kettle on. Gonna have a brew. Cause that's the first thing you should do. I'm gonna wait for summer. I'm gonna pick some crops.
Plenty of them.
Cause they taste much better than the crops bought from the shops. I'm gonna make a video. I'm gonna fool around
all the time.
Allotment life's much better. Cause I just think it's out.
Right, well that's that done. So now it's down to Mother Nature to get them seeds growing. I've also put some fleece over the potato trench area just to try and warm the soil up a bit, but make sure you put that down properly if you put it down. I'll show you that later. Anyway, what else I've been doing today is I've prepared where my peas are going to go, and I've got my latest skip find, which I'll tell you about later, because now I'm a bit parched. So I'm going to put the kettle on. First of all, I need to fill it though. See you in a bit. Right, as you can see, this bit's been turned over and rotovated and all that kind of thing. I've put some chicken pellets down because this is where my peas are going. And this is a skip find I was telling you about. Now, they look to me like two old painting staging things made of wood, obviously. Kind of sturdy though. So what I'm going to do is, because I love this kind of thing, I'm going to get some strings. The first row of peas that's in the gutter are going to go where that first bit is there, along there. So I'm going to put some string all the way across, and then in the middle, same again, that's where my other row of gutter and peas are going to go. And then by the time they've grew, I'm going to put a loose row outside, straight into the ground when it warms up a bit. So that's one skip find. I'll just take it down here because there's another skip find. There you are, check them out. canny good, canny good. Now there's a local school, and these are woodwork projects that the kids have made, which they don't like want to take home, obviously. So they end up going in a skip. Now look at that. Brendan, what do you think of that wood turning? That's all done on a lathe. Not bad. It's all a solid bit of wood and all. Look at the thickness. So what I was thinking of, because it looks like it's a book stand of some sort of description. It's got a bit of a slant on, and there has been something there. So what I was thinking about doing is taking the top off here, because it's all screwed in, and levelling it, making a bird table, because that's a solid bit of wood there. Either that, or I'll make a guitar out of it. Anyway, this is the other skip find. Look at this. Awesome, man. This was in the skip as well at the school. A little writing desk here. Look at that. Perfect. Put my seeds in there. Seeds and stuff. All the little notes that I need to make, which I've wrote upon my writing desk. Canny good. Canny good. All from a skip. Well, I'm going to finish my cuppa, and I'll show you around. See you in a bit. Okay, folks, that's it. I've had enough for the day, so I'll give you a quick run round of what's been happening. Me rhubarb, that's grown now, canny. As is everybody else's. I put some under this bucket, under this bin the other week. See how it's forced? There was nothing there last week, nothing. So I'll leave that bin over for a bit. That's where the seeds, the flower seeds, the different ones. I've sowed some wildflower seeds and some of that carpet of snow. So hopefully they will grow. I got some more pots from an empty allotment. Cool. Now this area is me pond, me boat pond. It will eventually, I'm going to get some pond flowers and put them in there, like water lilies and stuff. But everything's starting to grow, canny. The frogs spawning here will probably be tadpoles by now. There they are, aye. I can see them. What I'll have to do is get me tadpole calm back out. Roses are climbing up. This purple one is doing canny as well. So I should get some canny ones off there. That's my peas, where my peas are going to go this year. I've put some strawberries in as well. I've tidied this bit up, look, dug it over. These are blackcurrants. Blackcurrant, raspberry. There's a couple of raspberries here as well. And the rest's going to be strawberries. These here are the suckers from here. So I put them in last year, so now these are 2 years old, these are 1 year old. Then it's the suckers off them ones next year will go here, and they'll be the third years, and the next time they'll be ready to come out, so the suckers from there will go into there. Now that's the plan, because a strawberry plant will only last 4 years and they start turning like not very good. Anyway, I'm rambling on here. Aye, the weather. I wish I had got dug over. I was going to do a little bit planting today, but the weather's been too wet. And the garlic's coming on. So I give that a little bit feed of the chicken pellets as well. And my herbs doing canny. Yeah, I've covered over this potato trench with a bit fleece just to try and warm the soil up a bit. So I get 10 potatoes in that row there, and they'll be the Charlotte, because they need to go in soon, like. So like I say, they'll be going in within the next couple of weeks. I'll just pause it for a sec and I'm back. Now the comfrey, that's starting to grow. So like I was saying, what I'm going to do is dig the potato trench in a couple of weeks time, stick some of the comfrey in along the bottom and then fill the soil back in, put the taties on the bottom, etc, etc. Now, my onions were going to go out today. There they all are. Oh! In the car boot, cold frame, doing nicely, because that's another little tip. You don't want to, if something's been growing in the greenhouse, you don't want to put it straight out in the ground. Like, you need to harden it off a bit, because it will not like it. You wouldn't like it, so why would the plants like it? Anyway, my peas, they'll be going out in a couple of weeks. 100% germination. That's the Humax soil, that is. That's Humax compost for you folks. Same with my swede, they're all up. Apart from two. My turnips are starting to pop through now. There's all the cabbage and kale that I potted on earlier on. And my sunflowers. I've marked them all on there with a good old Sharpie. Where they're little yo. So I know exactly which one's which and which one's which and all that kind of thing. Now these mysterious sweet corn. They're not sweet corn. I'm going to chuck them. They're no good. I haven't even done anything since the last time. But these flowers have started coming up now. Carpet of snow. I can't remember that. Alyssum. Alyssum. Carpet of snow. And these ones have just started appearing. Which are Anopsis, early sunrise or something. Those ones haven't. So I've given them a water in there, and I've been putting this over. It seems to be doing the trick. Now, yeah, while I've got this in my hand, just as it's coming to my eye, this is a fid. Now, for those who think it's hard to grow parsnips and carrots and stuff, it isn't. All you need is one of these. Now, if you haven't already seen my videos, I'll be showing you about how to grow parsnips and stuff using the fid in a few weeks' time. It's far too early to grow parsnips at this time of year anyway, the winter crops, and it's not even really summer yet. I'm blabbering, folks, I'm blabbering. Right, I'll shut. Oh no, I'm forgetting to show you things, man. There's me beetroot. That's them broad beans. So they'll need to go out. Everything needs to go out soon now. Like, that's the cauliflower I sowed 2 weeks ago, if that. Now these are moringa. Now I don't think anything's going to happen to them. I've left them in there. I've kept watering them. See what happens. If not, nice try. And these auger, New Zealand yams, they've doubled in size since the last one. I might even have to put them into bigger pots soon. We'll see what happens anyway. Shut this for the night. And nip into the other greenhouse. See what's been happening there. Like I say, all my onions are out now, apart from these ones. These are the ones I started from seed. So I'll give them a go. The ones that I sowed a little bit later than that. That's them, and my leeks. Are just starting to come up. That's some of the cabbages I potted on last time I was here. Not bad. Getting there, the primo cabbages. More broad beans. No sign of the sweet corn yet. I potted on some of these nasturtiums as well. Canny. They'll be going on my little stand thing outside there. Soon, them peas will be going out as well. Like I say, they'll be going into the cold frame before they go into the ground. Same with the broad beans. What else is that? The comfrey experiment. Is starting still. There it is. It takes ages to dry out. Like, I'll have to try and invent some sort of way of drying it out. Well, I could stick it on the rocket stove, but that's another thing. I haven't got time for that. gonna nip into the shed, see what's been happening in here. Nothing much. I got some tomato plants off Ray. Sweet Million. Four. I need to pot them on soon. My potatoes are still chitting away. Been putting a... Oh, hello there, Willie. Oh, how are you doing?
Hey, Dave, I'm doing fine. How are you?
I'm all right. What are you doing, chilling in there?
Yeah. Now go crack on, because you're just blabbering on now, Dave.
Aye, I am. Right. In an empty garden up there, I found some perlite. A bag of that, so I'll be using that some stage. I also found a half a bag of horse manure from B&Q and some organic farming manure. There's half a bag of each of that. So I'll probably add that to my potatoes as well, because you can't get enough. Right, anyway, I'm going to quickly get changed. So if you give us 5 minutes and I'll see you on the chair. Bye. Right, I'm all done now. That's it. I'm away. I'm going to go and catch the bus. Going back up to Throckley for the night. Anyway, that's it, like I say. Thank you for watching. Thanks for subscribing and commenting and liking and everything, because it's all great. Since the last video, I've made another 50 subscribers, so excellent. Thank you very much to the new subscribers, welcome, and to the old subscribers, rock on. Anyway, what was I going to say? All right, the song, the sing-along song. Thank you for all the people who showed interest. I will be contacting you through YouTube. I'll let you know when I've sent you a private message. Let us know if you don't know how to get the private messages up, but 90% of the people that did the last two are doing the new one, so nice one. I'll leave it at that for now. Hopefully the weather will be a little bit better the next time I'm here, and I'll be able to start getting some stuff planted outside for a change, because it's that time of year. So once again, folks, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. I'll just leave you with a little joke. Oh no, wait, before I leave you with a little joke, going back to my gardening song, but I've wrote another one. It's in the process. I'll let my mate Jive Turkey tell you about that. So, see yous. I'll leave you with a little joke now. What? How does it go again? No. I was at this posh tea party the other day. I went, you know, afternoon tea, don't you know? And this posh woman come up to us and says, "Hello there, would you like a lemon slice or a meringue?" I says, "No, you're not wrong, I would like a lemon slice, but how did you know they were my favourites?" See you later, I'll get me coat.
Yeah, it's me, I'm back. My brother Dave has asked me to do something, and I'm going to do it because I think it's cool. Since the popularity of his last song, the Garden Allotment song, my man Dave, he's created a rap. He wants me to do it. Here's a little freestyle made up with the drum beats. I don't know if you can hear them, but I'm going to give it a go anyway. Springtime's here, it's time to get going. The plot's all dug, now it's time to start sowing. Seeds of many kinds and seeds of many colors. See you later, my sisters and the brothers.